story to tell. The Russian Air Force put into operation the first Su-57 fighter in December 2020, and it is expected that by 2027 there will be 76 aircraft. The Su-57 is currently considered a fifth-generation fighter, but the airframe has been used to test a number of weapons with sixth-generation technology, including hypersonic missiles, artificial intelligence, and unmanned aerial vehicles. The Su-57 will also be equipped with Saturn 30 engines from 2022, which will significantly improve its flight performance and range, which is already among the highest in the world and is well suited to the Russian Air Force's long-range trial operations. Despite its impressive performance, the potential of any fighter in air combat depends heavily on the air-to-air missiles it carries. Most Russian fighters, including the most advanced Su-35 today, use the R-27 long-range air-to-air missile. This is a modernized variant based on a missile developed by the Soviet Union during the Cold War. The R-27 is the world's most advanced semi-active radar homing missile, but its capabilities are far behind that of modern missiles using active radar guidance, such as the US AIM-120, Europe's Meteor, or China's PL-15. Russia has developed a new specialized long-range air-to-air missile, the K-77M, developed for the Su-57 to give it an edge over its main competitors. With a range of over 190 kilometers, this is not the longest air-to-air missile Russia has developed. But in general, K-77M is the most complex air-to-air missile that Russia has ever built. The K-77 has a range longer than the top American missile, the AIM-120D, which reaches 180 kilometers, but short of the Chinese PL-15, which reaches an estimated 250 to 300 kilometers. What makes the K-77's introduction particularly significant, aside from its more compact size and longer range, is the fact that its active phased array antenna guidance technologies make it extremely accurate even against small and agile targets at extreme ranges. A sophisticated radar system in the missile's nose can overcome the radar's field of view problem to retain a lock 360 degrees around itself, and thereby preventing fighters from evading its field of view by ducking past it. This will provide the missile with a no-escape range several times as long as that on the R-77, and much longer than those of the AIM-120D or PL-15. Russian state media outlet RT explained the active phased array antenna technology used by the K-77 as follows. An active phased array antenna consists of a large number of cone-shaped cells installed under a transparent to radio waves cap on the nose of the missile. Each cell received only a part of the signal, but once digitally processed, The information from own cells is summarized into a full picture, enabling the K-77M missile to immediately respond to sharp turns of the target, making interception practically inevitable. Integration of the K-77 is but the latest example of the Su-57 fighter pioneering groundbreaking new technologies, which other countries may early later begin to develop themselves. In addition to the Su-57, the K-77M missile can be used to arm other Russian fighters, such as the Su-35, Su-30SM2, and Su-27SM2, all of which have relatively modern radars suitable for guiding the K-77M. The K-77M missile will be the key to partially restoring Russia's missile advantage and preparing the Russian efforts to face next-generation threats, such as the future US missile AIM-260. My video about the K-77M long-range missile answer. Thank you for watching. If you find this video interesting, please give me your thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to support the channel. Goodbye and see you again in the next videos. Tạm biệt và hẹn gặp lại quý vị và các bạn trong các video tiếp theo.